Hi guys, welcome back to Relax My Cat. It's Claire and Rex, and today I'm going to be telling you how you can tell if your cat has worms. Now, all cats of all ages all around the world are at risk of picking up worms. So Rexy and I are going to be telling you a few symptoms to look out for if your cat has contracted roundworms, tapeworms or lungworms. Now, roundworms, as their name suggests, are long and round, and their eggs are in your cat's feces. Though, unlike other worms, these eggs cannot be seen by the naked eye, so it is important to know what symptoms to look out for to see if your cat has been infected with roundworms. These symptoms include sickness, diarrhea, weight loss even though your cat is eating properly, a dull coat, lack of energy and a swollen or distended stomach. Now, this is a symptom that is in all cats, but is a little bit more noticeable if your kitten has been infected with roundworm, as obviously their bodies are a lot smaller, so the increased stomach will look a lot more obvious, though it is quite easy to see it in a full-grown cat as well. If your cat is showing any of these symptoms, get them to the vet to get diagnosed and treated. The next is tapeworms, and again, as their name suggests, these worms are long, tapered, ribbony, cream-coloured creatures, and their eggs can actually be seen in your cat's feces by the naked eye. Now, these egg sacs look a little bit like miniature grains of rice, so if you notice these in your cat's poo, quite likely they have tapeworm, so get into the vets, like I've said before. Now, cats tend to get tapeworm if they've had fleas. Sometimes in fleas' bodies, there are tapeworm larvae. So if your cat has fleas and they've been grooming themselves and accidentally ingest a flea, then it's quite likely they're gonna get infected with tapeworm. And finally, lungworm. And again, like their name suggests, these worms live in your cat's lungs. Though fortunately, unlike dogs, it's very rarely fatal in cats, though it can cause breathing problems and lung damage. Now, lungworms actually come from infected slugs and snails, and it's very unlikely that a cat will eat a slug or a snail, but if you have a cat who is a prolific hunter, so they eat rodents who may have eaten a slug or a snail that has lungworm, quite likely they're going to get infected with lungworm. So these kinds of cats are more at risk of contracting lungworm. But what are the symptoms to look out for? Well, quite obviously, cats who are infected with lungworm will have wheezing, coughing and difficulty breathing. Again, like I said, if you notice any of these symptoms in your cat, take them to the vet to get diagnosed and treated. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you found this video interesting, and if you've got any additional advice on cats and worms, please feel free to leave them in the comments section below. And hey, don't forget to check out the Relax My Cat podcast. Myself and Sav, who's the other vlogger here on Relax My Cat, do a weekly podcast. We are absolutely loving doing it. It's so much fun, and you guys seem to be really enjoying it as well. If you've not checked it out, just look in the description box below. I'll leave a link to the podcast there. If you did enjoy the video, guys, please give us a big thumbs up. It helps us out loads. And if you've not subscribed already, just hit the button in the middle there. And while you're at it, head on over to the other side of the screen to see our vlog from last week and give that a bit of love as well. Thanks again for watching, guys, and Roxy and I will see you in our next video. Bye!